hydrogen chloride reacts with ammonia to produce high dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. Similarly, the most important news regarding HCl is 1:3 ratio of 1:3 ratio of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated HCl mixture is called as aqua regia. So this is the most important expected question, 2 marks question during IPE examination. What is aqua regia? Here 1:3 ratio of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated HCl mixture is called as aqua regia. It is a strong oxidizing agent. It works as strong oxidizing agent. Even it reacts with noble metals. It reacts with noble metals like gold and platinum. So let us have the chemical reaction. Au plus HNO3 generally dissociates to produce nitrates plus H plus. The reaction expected between this HCl to produce AuCl, Rm chloride. So we can write it as AuCl4 minus plus the formation of NO plus H2O. Similarly, we can write it as platinum is also reacts with aqua regia, NO3 minus and HCl to produce platinum tetrachloride plus formation of NO plus formation of NO and water molecule. So these are the chemical reactions generally exhibited by these species. It is chemical behavior of HCl, hydrogen chloride. Once again, let us have uses. It is used in medicine field and laboratory. It is used as a reagent in medicine field and laboratory. Here, hydrochloric acid widely used to produce ammonium chloride and also glucose from corn starch. For the production of glucose from corn starch, we have to use hydrochloric acid. Similarly, it is useful to produce glue from bones and also purification of bone powder. So these are the uses identified with hydrogen chloride. This is the discussion related to HCl, hydrochloric acid. Next one, after completion of our discussion with HCl, the next topic is oxoacids. Oxoacids. Here, 7th A group elements are 17th group elements by reacting with oxygen and hydrogen can produce different types of oxoacids. So we can write it as, I would like to give it in a table form. Hypohalous acid, halic acid, perhalic acid. So most importantly, 4 types of oxoacids resulting when halogens reacts with hydrogen and oxygen. They named as hypohalous acid, halous acid, halic acid, perhalic acid. We can write it as halic 1 acid. Hypohalous acids are also called as halic 1 acid. Halous acids are also called as halic 3 acid. And halic acids are called as halic 5 acids. And perhalic acids are called as halic 7 acids. As we explained in our previous class, halogens will generally represent 4 oxidation states, minus 1 or plus 1, next plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. So this is, let us come to the concept of oxidation states in oxoacids. In hypohalous acids, the halogens will exhibit plus 1 oxidation state, sometimes minus 1 oxidation state, especially in case of fluorine. Whereas in case of halous acids, the oxidation state of halogens will be with plus 3. And in halic acids, plus 5 oxidation state. In perhalic acids, plus 7 oxidation states. The special news regarding fluorine can form only one oxoacid. Only one oxoacid due to less atomic size and more electronegativity. Fluorine can exhibit only one oxoacid, HOF. The name of this compound is hypofluorous acid. So let us have different halogen or oxoacids of halogen atoms. I would like to take here fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So in a table form we can represent. Fluorine can form only one type of oxoacid, which represented as HOF, which is called as hypofluorous acid. Similarly, chlorine also produces this type of oxoacid, which having the general molecular formula HOCl, we can call it as hypochlorous acid, HOBr, hypobromous acid, HOI, hypoiodous acid. So hypofluorous acid, hypochlorous acid, hypobromous acid, hypoiodous acid. Similarly, fluorine cannot form halic 3 acids, halic 5 acids, halic 7 acids. Why? Because why it never produces this? Only the reason for this is due to more electronegativity and less atomic size, it never exhibit plus 3, plus 7, plus 5 oxidation states. Whereas chlorine can form HClO2, HClO3, HClO4 type of oxoacids. Once again, hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid and perchloric acid. Similarly, bromine and iodine never forms halic 3 acids, or the formed halic 3 acids are somewhat less stable. Sometimes the oxoacids resulting from halogens may not be stable. They are available in their aqueous form or salt form. So here, bromine can form HBrO3, bromic acid, HBrO4. What is this? Perbromic acid. Similarly, iodine can also produce HIO3, iodic acid, HIO4, periodic acid. So these are the different oxoacids released from or produced from halogens by reacting with hydrogen and oxygen. Among all these oxoacids, Oxoacids of chlorine. Oxoacids of chlorine are important. Chlorine are important. Are somewhat more stable when compared to remaining element oxoacids. So let us have structures of these HOCl. What is the name of this compound? Hypochlorous acid. The hypochlorous acid will be represented as OHCl. This is the structure of hypochlorous acid. Whereas the structure of chlorous acid HOCl2 is called as chlorous acid. The chlorous acid will be represented as chlorine. It is connected to double bond O and OH. Similarly, the structure of HClO3, what is the compound name? This oxoacid is called as chloric acid. This will be represented as ClOH, double bond O and double bond O. Similarly, the last type of oxoacid resulting from chlorine is chloric acid, perchloric acid. This will be represented as chlorine. It is connected to OH. It is connected to double bond O, double bond O and double bond O. So this is what the structure of hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid and perchloric acid. So these are the oxoacids resulting from halogens. The most important halogens, somewhat more stable halogens, oxoacids resulting from chlorine. They are hypochlorous acid, chlorous acid, chloric acid and perchloric acid. So this is about oxoacids.